Well done, friend. Very well done. Apologies for my temper tantrum there. You are with the good guys, I promise. We'll keep you safe. Trust me. Go on back to work. We'll be in touch.
Our researchers looked into the life of Altair Ibn Lahed, hoping to find a biography that might serve as a positive role model for Abstergo's global outreach programs. Unfortunately, this renegade assassin proved to be no such thing. In much of his footage, we see a man gleefully flouting some of his culture's most entrenched taboos with an arrogance that borders on messianic.
Altair! No! This is not our way! To burn a man's body is forbidden!
Many of our researchers felt that the arguments articulated by Altair's rival, a man known as Abbas, were clearer and more cogent than any we heard from Altair. I've recently put in a request that more effort be dedicated to locating one of Abbas's descendants, if any exist. It's clear to us that Altair's transgressions were the primary motivation behind the ultimate dissolution of his despicable order by the middle of the 13th century. We therefore strongly recommend a pass on this property, in favor of a more agreeable and inspiring figure from this era.
few times to record anything. Hey, Dad. So, we're all here in New York at the motel. It's, Queens, actually. In Astoria, near the Ant Q. Rebecca's off getting batteries for something. Sean's in his room doing whatever Sean does. And, you're out getting some food. Me? Well, I'm supposed to be getting ready to break into some offices in the financial district. Feels just like prepping for one of your old training drills, actually. 10 years go by, and then you show up, and it's like I was never gone. And we're right back to the ball busting and the conspiracies and the paranoia. Only this time, I believe you. I believe every word. You know, I don't even think you know the half of it. I don't think you know how much I've seen, how much I've learned in just a few weeks. Everything, really. I feel like I've lived 1,000 years, or 10,000, maybe. It's impossible to explain. But when you see that much of the world through the eyes of so many, can't help but be sad. And to see all these incredible, intelligent people fight the same battles, make the same mistakes over and over again. Because culture and knowledge and history, these things, they aren't passed on through our genes. Every kid on Earth needs to relearn the basics. How to live, how to survive, how to stand up for what's right. So much is lost in the transfer. So much is added, every generation. It's a shame. And over and over, everything must be learned again. I met Clay, Dad. Clay Gesmeric, in the Animus. I knew him by his Abstergo handle, Subject 16. My predecessor. And he showed me things. He passed them to me just before he died. Or got deleted or whatever. Everything he'd learned, everything he'd seen. God, how do I talk about this? So, guess you trained him. After I left, he really looked up to you, and now that I've seen through his eyes, I think I understand why. I'm glad you had him around, even if I wasn't there. The things he showed me. Unbelievable things. And I never... Shit. All right, back in a second.
minutes after loading it up. Security.
Get hacked, did you?
Got detail up front this morning?
Thank you.
I wish I could say this was illegal, but they actually have... like rifles. Grabbing people's IDs.
In the parking garage at my desk. That was the end of it. I can't be responsible for other...
I did this for more than an hour. I had similar kinds of effects.